हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू आवर साइंस क्लास. सो आई अप्रिशिएट एवरी वन हु हैव कम्प्लीटेड टर्म वन एंड टर्म टू. नाउ वी आर एंटरिंग इन टू टर्म थ्री. सो दिस इज़ योर फर्स्ट साइंस क्लास इन टर्म थ्री. ओके, सो दिस इज़ योर फ्रंट पेज ऑफ योर बुक. यू कैन सी दिस. दिस इज़ योर फ्रंट पेज ऑफ योर बुक. सो इन दिस Term 3, we have 3 lessons. How many lessons? 3 lessons. Okay. So, you can see the screen now. The first lesson is green environment. What is the first lesson? Green environment. The second lesson, life of animals. And the third lesson, air we breathe. Okay. So, we have only 3 lessons. So, now we are going to enter into the first lesson, that is green environment. Okay, so in the first lesson you are going to learn about the importance of environment, the conservation of environment, eco-friendly materials, and in the second lesson, life of animals, we are going to learn group behavior in animals, adaptation in animals, structure of insects, and parental care in animals. Okay. And the third lesson, air we breathe, we are going to learn, know that air is a mixture, understand the composition and components of air, explain air pollution and its effects. Okay, so these are the 3 lessons. So first we'll move to the first lesson, that is green environment. So here we have our first lesson, green environment. So, our learning objectives. So, after the completion of this unit, students will be able to understand the importance of waste management. Okay. So, the main reason you are going to learn this lesson is everyone should understand the importance of environment and how we have to save our environment. Okay. So, understand the role of 3 R's in waste management. So this and all you'll be learning in the next videos. Okay, so first we'll go into the introduction part. Okay, nature provides us a lot of useful things. How many of you agree this? Yes, our nature, it gives us a lot of useful things. Without nature we can't live. Only nature gives us everything, right? But human beings exploit the natural resources and create more trash. So nature provides many gifts to us. But what do our human beings will do? They will spoil the gift which provides by the nature. Right? So these unwanted materials thrown away are called wasters. Okay, the unwanted materials thrown away by human beings are known as wasters. Okay, so what is waste? The unwanted materials thrown away are called waste. They can be solid, liquid and gas. Okay, so we have 3 types of wastes. Okay, so solid waste, liquid waste and gas waste. They are produced from households, industries, hospitals, etc. So all the wastes we get from households are known as household waste, industries are known as industries waste, and hospitals are known as hospital waste. Okay, so from household things, from industrial and from hospital, we get many waste items. Okay, so these unwanted materials pollute our environment. Okay, so the unwanted waste material will definitely pollute our environment. So we should be careful in saving our environment. Okay, so here waste management. Now we are going to learn about the waste management. They have given a conversation part here, the conversation between a student and a teacher. Okay, okay, first Sristika, what she is asking, madam, I see a lot of wastings in our surrounding. Is there any way we can reduce wasting things? What she is asking, she's asking to her teacher that I can see a lot of waste things around our environment. So she is asking any solution. Is there any way we can reduce wasting things? So for that, the teacher is replying, yes, there are many ways to reduce waste. So for every problem, we have solution, right? So for reducing waste also, we have solution. So reducing the waste is the first and most important step in waste management. Okay, how we can manage the waste management? Yes, reducing the waste. This is the first and most important step in waste management. If we follow reducing the waste, we can save our environment. Okay, so after that, Vimal is asking, what is waste management, madam? And teacher is replying, it is the step we take to handle our waste and to make sure our environment does not get dirty and polluted. So it is a step we take to handle our waste. What is waste management? It is a step to handle our waste and make sure our environment does not get dirty and polluted. So waste management are the steps we taken to save our environment from dirty and polluted. Okay, so waste management deals with both biodegradable and non-biodegradable waste. Okay, what is biodegradable and non-biodegradable waste? Yes, biodegradable waste means decomposed easily. The waste which gets decomposed easily are known as biodegradable waste. Okay, so for example, all the plant items. Okay, so the plant items, the skin of onions, the skin of any vegetables, it comes under biodegradable waste. Okay, because we can easily decompose biodegradable waste. Okay, and what is non-biodegradable waste? It is just opposite to biodegradable waste. Non-biodegradable waste means we cannot decompose it. Okay, so those waste are known as non-biodegradable waste. Okay, then Janani is asking, can you please explain the steps in waste management, madam? So she is eagerly asking about the steps in waste management because she has interest in saving the environment. So that she is asking the steps in waste management. Okay, for that the teacher is telling that, yes, sure, there are four steps in waste management. You have to underline all these four steps. Take your pencil and underline this. The first step is separation of waste. What is the first step? Separation of waste. And the second step, waste collection and transportation. What is the second step? Waste collection and transportation. And the third step, waste recycling and composting. Fourth step, waste disposal. So if you doesn't have book, you can write all these 4 points in your rough note. Okay, so this 4 point is very important. So these are the 4 steps in waste management. What are the 4 steps? One is separation of waste. The second one, waste collection and transportation. Third one, water recycling and composting. And the fourth one is waste disposal. Okay, now we are going to learn the steps one by one. Okay, so the first step, what is the first step? Separation of waste. Okay, so here we can see 3 different color dustbin, right? Okay, now we are going to learn about the separation of wastes. Okay, so this is a very important step in waste management. This is the first and important step in waste management. Separation of waste is the first and important step in waste management. It means to sort or divide the waste into different waste bins. Okay, so what is the main process in this separation of waste is division. Okay, dividing the waste into different waste bin, different color waste bin. We are going to divide the wastes according to the process. If the waste is biodegradable, we are going to throw the waste in biodegradable dustbin. If the waste is recyclable, we can throw this recyclable waste in blue color dustbin. And the waste, if the waste is non-recyclable, we can throw that waste in red color dustbin. Okay, so each bin should have different types of waste. We have to separate the waste. This is the first step in waste management. It is good to separate waste in three different bins. So green is for biodegradable waste, blue is for recyclable waste, and red is for non-recyclable waste. Okay, so we have three dustbins. One is green color, second one is blue color, and third one is red color. Okay, so the first one, green color, biodegradable waste, and the second one, blue color, is recyclable waste, and the third one, red color, is non-recyclable waste. Okay, so non-biodegradable waste can be classified as recyclable and non-recyclable. Okay, so non-biodegradable waste means recyclable and non-recyclable. Okay, so what we are going to do, we are going to separate the wastes in the first step. Okay, we are going to take green color dustbin, blue color dustbin, and red color dustbin. Green color dustbin is for biodegradable waste, the waste which decomposes easily. Okay, for example, all the wastes from kitchen, the wastes from vegetable, fruits, the skin of vegetables, fruits, all these things will comes under biodegradable. And recyclable means the wastes which we can recycle. For example, glass, paper, plastics. Okay, so some plastics can be recyclable and non-recyclable. So those plastics which can be recyclable are thrown into blue color dustbin. Next one, non-recyclable. Okay, this is not able to recycle. Okay, for example, chewing gum. Okay, and some type of plastic is also comes under non-recyclable waste. Okay, so what is the first step? Separation of waste. We are going to separate the waste into three category. One is biodegradable, recyclable, and non-recyclable. Okay, so the next step, what waste collection and transportation. Once we separate our waste in our homes and schools, it is important to keep it ready to be picked up by our municipality or corporation. Picking up the waste is called waste collection. So what is waste collection? Picking up the waste by municipality or corporation are known as waste collection. Okay, we have to collect the waste and we have to wait for the corporation or municipality to collect the waste. Okay, so moving the waste from one place to another is called transportation. So in daily morning we can see this type of waste container, right? So this container will come to our home, it will collect all the wastes and it will go, right? So the collection of waste are known as waste collection, and moving the waste from one place to another is called transportation. Okay, the next, third one, water recycling and composting. Biodegradable waste is taken to a place where it can be converted into compost. So what the biodegradable waste, it will taken to a place where it can be converted into compost. Okay, so biodegradable, it can be easily decomposed, right? So by using the biodegradable waste compost, we can create compost. Compost means in Tamil we can say uram, right? For a plant and all, we will apply uram, right? So from biodegradable waste we can get compost. Okay, so compost makes the soil fertile. So for why we are adding this compost to the soil or to the plant? The plant will grow nicely if we add the compost. Okay, for the soil fertile, we are adding the compost. If we add the compost, the plant will grow nicely because the soil will get all the nutrients. Okay, so non-biodegradable waste that can be turned into something new and valuable is taken to recycling factory. Okay, so here biodegradable waste is converted into compost for the soil fertile, and non-biodegradable waste is taken to the recycling factory. Okay, next, the last step. So here we can see, right? So the first image is composting. Okay, here we can see this is the composting. Biodegradable waste are converted into composting. And in the second picture we can see many plastic items, right? Water bottles. So these and all we cannot decompose. So it is taken to the factory for recycling. Okay, so the last step, waste disposal. The waste that can be recycled needs to be sent for final disposal. Okay, so the waste which are not recycled or sent to the factory for the final disposal. So this waste is sent to an open dump or landfill. Okay, the waste which are not recycled will be sent to a open dump. Okay, or landfills. So here we can see many pictures, trash box, recycling, sorting, transportation, collection. So here, which is the first step? Collection is the first step. Then, which is the second step? Trash box is the first step, collection is the second step, transportation is the third step, sorting is the fourth step, and recycling is the fifth step. Okay. So till this we have completed. The next class we will be learning the remaining things. If you have any doubt, you can ask me in the Zoom class. Thank you, students.